وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Now it's very important. This third category of people, as I told you, one type of people who accept that da'wah, that call, that ideology, and then they plunge into deep waters, risking everything. Other one, they have rejected the ideology, rather they have decided to oppose it, and they are opposing it tooth and nail. And then this third group is in between. They want to make peace between evil and good, between batil and haq. They want to make peace between them. Because if there is a clash between the batil and the haq, between the truth and the falsehood, if there is a clash, there is going to be bloodshed, there is going to be loss of life, loss of property, loss of conveniences, everything. So actually they want peace, not for the sake of their truth, but for themselves, to save themselves. That is why they wanted to say, that why are we going to war? It's no use going to war against kuffar. Why not go on preaching and preaching and teaching and teaching? Well, we can preach Islam. We can teach Islam to the people. Why Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has taken this way? He started sending small groups of armies, small groups, obstructing the way of the caravans, of the Quraysh. What for? Why? This will lead to bloodshed. This will lead to war, to battles. We shouldn't do it. We should make peace. Now this character, you must read between the lines. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْلِحُونَ. When it is said to them, don't make mischief on the earth, they say, oh no, we are the peacemakers. What was the mischief? Muslims, the true Mu'mins, said to them, if you accepted Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the messenger of Allah, if you accepted Islam, then be true Muslims. Now obey him in every respect. When you have accepted him, now you have to obey him. Why you know this difference of opinion? This is actually mischief. This is fasad. La tufsidu fil ard. There is a party. You are breaking the discipline of the party. This party must be disciplined. Bunyanun marsus. Inna Allah yuhibbu allazeena yuqatiluna fi sabeelihi saffan ka'annahum bunyanun marsus. You should be like, you know, a fortified wall. Not different people, individuals, you know. So this group should be very much integrated. And why are you making this facade? And the reply was, قَالُوا إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْلِحُونَ. No, we want to make peace. Muhammad wants to make war, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we want to obstruct this war-mongering. We want to have peace. أَلَا إِنَّهُمْ هُمُ الْمُفْسِدُونَ. Now this is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen, they are the mischief mongers. وَلَاكِ اللَّهِ يَشْعُرُونَ. But they don't have the perception, they perceive not. But they are the mischief mongers. Why? Because actually, whenever on this earth there is some system which is not the system of Deen of Allah, this is fasad. Although there might be all amn, all peace, apparent peace, but actually when this is not the law of Allah which is governing this place, it is in rebellion against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is fasad. Zahara al-fasadu fil barri wal bahr bima kasabat yadin nas. This is fasad. This is rebellion against the rightful ruler. The rightful owner of this universe is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the only rightful ruler. And if anybody else, any other law is ruling, it is rebellion. So this rebellion has to be set under. It has to be controlled. It has to be dealt with. And for dealing with this rebellion, putting it down, you need a party, strong party, powerful party, disciplined party. Now if you are making injuries to the discipline of that party, you are weakening that party, you are abetting this system actually, this facade. So Quran says, Ala innahum humul mufsidun. By breaking the discipline of the Muslim party, of Hizbullah, of the party of Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are the mischief mongers. They are abetting and supporting this facade on earth. Ala innahum humul mufsiduna walakin la yashurun. Wa idha qila lahum aminu kama amana nas. And when it is said to them, you should also believe just as the others have believed, You look to Abu Bakr, look to Umar, look to Saad ibn Ma'az, look to Saad ibn Ubadah, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in. They are the believers. Why don't you follow them? Why don't you take to their examples? What did they say? Very interesting. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَا. They said, should we believe just as these fools are believing? They thought they are fools. They are fanatics. They are risking everything. These are fools who have left their homes and hearts and they have come over from Makkah to Medina. Are they, you know, wise people? They don't look to whatever is injurious to them, whatever is harmful to them, whatever is beneficial for them. They have just migrated from Makkah, leaving their families, their home, not only their homes and hearts, their families at the mercy of the wolves of Makkah. They have come over here. So they are fools. Actually, we are not fools like them. We are not going to risk our lives and properties and our wealth. We are not going to take that path. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَاءُ أَلَا إِنَّهُمْ هُمُ السُّفَهَاءُ وَلَٰكِنْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Listen to it. Hearken. They are the fools, but they don't have the perception. They don't have the knowledge. Abu Bakr is not a fool. Umar is not a fool. And Saad ibn Ubadah and Saad ibn Ma'az, they are not fools. These are fools. Abdullah ibn Ubay is the biggest fool of Medina. And the people who are like him, people who are obeying him, people who are taking his part, they are the fools. Because actually they don't know what is really good and beneficial for them. Because real life is the life hereafter. And this is injurious for them. Because we read in Surah An-Nisa, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. These munafiqeen will be in the lowest part of hell, in the lowest section of hell, they will be placed. So actually they are fools. وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا. And when they meet the people who believe, really believe, they say, we also believe. وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ. Now this is a word, please note. When they are in privacy with their devils, with their chiefs, well, these are the chiefs, the Jews of Medina. The munafiqeen were actually, they were in close liaison with the Jews of Medina. وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ. There they say, we are with you. Don't think, although we have openly declared ourselves to be Muslims, to be with the Muslims, to be with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but this is also, we are making mockery of them. We are with you really. We have not left your side. We are with you. وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا. وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَهْزِئُونَ. We are only mocking. We are these fools, you know, these moments, they are fools. And we are making a laughing stock for them. اللَّهُ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. Now this is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mocks at them. وَيَمُدُّهُمْ فِي تُغْيَانِهِمْ. Again the same divine habit or divine rule or the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whichever path you take, Allah makes it easy for you. وَيَمُدُّهُمْ فِي تُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them increase in their wrongdoings, permits them going more and more in the direction of that evil and wrong path that they have taken and decided and chosen for themselves. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ اشْتَرَوُوا الضَّلَالَةَ بِالْهُدَىٰ. They are the people who have purchased error, falsehood, in exchange for guidance. Very beautiful words. Now guidance of the Qur'an came to them. Now they have two options. Either accept the guidance of the Qur'an, or the opposite of it, that's the falsehood, that is batil, that is error, that is sin, that is disobedience to Allah. Actually now, they have given away the guidance of Quran, guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and taken for themselves, accepting for themselves, they have exchanged the guidance for zalala, for the error, the falsehood. فَمَا رَبِحَتْ تِجَارَتُهُمْ. And this trade of theirs, it has not benefited them at all. This is the the sort of tafsirah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a commentary from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أولئك الذين اشتروا الضلالة بالهدى فما ربحت تجارتهم وما كانوا مهتدين. And they are not going to reach the destiny. They cannot have now the guidance because they have gone very far on this path of nifaq and munafiqah.